verse 6. Today we shall be doing the last part on your topic, South America. Okay, so today we are going to discuss about water resources and wildlife. Now, in South America, you know that you have your river, famous river, the river Amazon. Okay, so river Amazon passes through very dense forest. So because of which, much water of the river Amazon cannot be used for various purposes. Okay, so let's have a look at the water resources. So Amazon River carries vast quantity of water, but as its flow is gradual, without any sharp or steep valley, except for some parts in Andes, it has not been much used for electric power generation. Now, since the river Amazon has a large volume of water, but it does not have a large amount of waterfalls. Okay, so the flow of the river is not very fast. Okay, that means the speed of the river Amazon is not very fast, so it cannot be used for generation of hydroelectricity. Now, but there are some small rivers descending from the Andes and Brazilian highlands and have been used for generation of hydroelectricity. But there are other small rivers. Now, since they are falling from a height from the Andes, from the Brazilian highlands, so those water, okay, can be used for the generation of hydroelectricity. Now, South America has vast source of water, but they have not been fully harnessed. Harnessed means it has not been used to its fullest. So in South America, the water is used for many purposes. So what are the uses of the water? Hydroelectric power generation, that is only those rivers which fall from a height, is it? So since they are falling from a height, they are able to give energy, and that energy can be used for the generation of electricity. And irrigation means artificially watering the land, fishing and navigation, etc. So a large amount of fish can also be caught from the rivers, and then it is used for navigation. Navigation means when you want to go from one place to another, you can make use of the river water, okay, with the help of boats or steamers. So Brazil leads in hydroelectric power generation, followed by Argentina, Paraguay and Venezuela. So in Brazil, a large amount of river water can be harnessed for the generation of hydroelectricity, and then there are countries like Argentina, Paraguay and Venezuela where the river can be harnessed for the generation of hydroelectricity. Now we move on to the wildlife. So in the previous classes we have had a look at the different physical features of South America, the different climatic regions of South America. So because of which there are wide varieties of animals, wildlife animals found in the continent of South America. Now in the Amazon forest, okay, so in the Amazon forest you have colorful birds, monkeys, insects, snakes such as the python and the anaconda. In the Amazon forest means the thick forest, okay, you can get animals like the pythons and the anaconda. And you have reptiles such as crocodiles, alligators and fish, including the piranha. Piranha is also a very poisonous fish, okay. So these are the different animals, see, crocodile, alligator and piranha, found in the Amazon forest of South America. Then in the other parts, you can find the puma, the tapir, okay, the tapir giant, anteater, sloth, puma and the armadillo are also found in the Amazon region. So different varieties of animals are found there. Now in the tropical region, you have birds like toucans, egrets, hummingbirds, parrots and flamingos. So these are the types of birds found in the tropical region. And then in the pampas, you find large ostrich-like rear, okay, looks like ostrich. And then animal called guanaco is related to the camel family, but has the head and ears similar to a mule, legs like a stag and a deer. Different types of animals are found in this region. Then you can also get the pampas deer. Then the pampas deer and the jaguar of the cat family also found in the pampas region. Different types of wildlife. Then when you move on to the Andes, okay? And in the Andes, what you get is large praying birds such as the condor. That means praying means now they will be looking at their victims, which is a weak victim. How can I eat that victim? Isn't it? So large praying birds like condor are found there. The vicuna, alpaca, and llama are believed to belong to the camel family. So these sure-footed, long-eared animals can withstand the severe cold in the Andes. So they can withstand the cold climate of Andes. So it can survive in that type of climate. And then you have the alpaca and the llamas also found there, like a camel. Then in the Atacama Desert, where there is very less amount of water, less amount of rainfall, so you have rodents, geckos, and iguanas abundant in the desert sands. So you have, okay, this type of animals are found there. And in the Galapagos Islands, that is off coast of Ecuador, mainly inhabited by giant turtles, lizards, and a variety of birds are found there. So, these were some of the animals which are found in the continent of South America. So, we have come to the end of the lesson. So, what I would like you all to do is go through the water resources and the wildlife once again. Okay? And very shortly, we will be sending you the homework which is related to this particular chapter. So I hope we have done the previous work or previous question and answers which has been sent in the past, as well as the map work which we had given you. Okay, so we come to the end of the lesson, and whatever work will be sent in the days to come, we do it properly and go on revising. Now since we've come to the end of the syllabus, so we are just left with two case studies. So for that two case studies, we will be sending you the question answer, because you can read it on your own. There's not much of explanation. You read it on your own. So we will be sending you all the work which is associated with those two case studies. Okay. So what I would like you all to do is go on revising. Please revise the entire chapters which we have completed so far. Okay. So till then, stay safe, stay home. Have a nice day.